Okay, Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, you guys asked me so many questions about autophagy fasting that I've taken all the information on autophagy fasting and I put it in one video for you to have a turnkey system that you can just jump into autophagy fasting whenever you want. So get ready, take notes. There's a lot of great info here. Okay, you guys, let's talk about autophagy fasting. So on this video, I want to show you why you would do autophagy fasting, like where do you fit it into your fasting lifestyle. I want to talk about how you do it and how often you might want to do it. This has no doubt been the most favorite fast that we've done in my resetter group. And it's a lot of it is because of the results that people are getting. So let's start off with why you would do it, and then I'll jump into how you do it. So a lot of you guys are doing one meal a day. This is very common. You know, the fasting world has blossomed out of the great work of Dr. Jason Fung and out of Dr. Valter Longo's work, where we learned that the longer you fast, the more you can regenerate the immune system, you can secrete stem cells, you can tap into autophagy. But we also learned that you can lose a lot of weight. So what happens to a lot of fasters is they get stuck in this one meal a day idea where they're fasting all day and then they're just eating one meal a day. And the challenge with that is if there's no variation in your fasting style, in your eating style, eventually your body gets stuck. And this is what I was seeing in my resetter group. We had all these fasters that would tell me these stories about how they started off doing fabulous with keto, fabulous with fasting, and then they hit a wall. So out of studying, you know, Dr. Osumi's work on autophagy, looking at Naomi Whittle has a protein cycling fast or 15-day experience that she has people go through. Looking at what stimulates autophagy, like keeping your protein low, I discovered something called autophagy fasting. And it is perfect for those of you that are trying to drop more weight or you're stuck with the other styles of fasting and eating that you've been doing. So I like it to unstick you. This is my preferred way to get you to go to that next layer of healing, to get you to go to that next layer of weight loss. So how do you do it? So there are some very specific parameters that you need to follow to stimulate autophagy. And those parameters really involve two things. One, you've got to fast at least 17 hours. So the sweet spot for autophagy is between 17 and 72 hours. So if you have been an intermittent faster where you're going 13 hours or 15 hours, this is a great next step for you on your path to longer fasts. So in order to get to hit autophagy, you have to go at least 17 hours, okay? The second requirement is that you're going to have to keep your protein under 20 grams. Now, here's the question we get a lot from people, which is animal protein or no animal protein in autophagy fasting. So you can do animal protein in autophagy fasting. It just has to be under 20 grams. So this includes, you got to count your butter if you put it in your coffee, you put your cream in your coffee, like every little bit of protein is going to add up. When we first did this fast with my resetters, we did it like in 2018, about December 2018, when I rolled out this fast to them, the big aha that everybody had was, oh my gosh, there's protein in everything. So vegetables even have protein. So if this is a new style of fasting for you, you're gonna need to count the protein in everything, which is why I love Carb Manager. It's a great measurement for you to track your food because you may be surprised that you're eating more protein than you think. So you gotta go at least 17 hours and then you've got to keep your protein under 20 grams. Those are critical for stimulating autophagy, okay? The other piece that we learned from Naomi Whittle's book, Glow 15, is, and I really like this one because it helps a lot of my resetters go a little bit longer with their fast, is that when you do decide to break your fast, you want to break it with fat. So the idea behind that is you've now gone 17 hours, you've stimulated autophagy, and fat typically for most people will not raise your blood sugar. So most people can break their fast with fat, and then they can even go a couple of more hours. Now, the trick that my resetters found was, well, what fat do you recommend we break it with? If I like nut butters, problem with nut butters is that you're gonna end up with the protein being high again. I live in California. We have access to avocados all the time, so I recommend that people break it with avocado. You could just eat a whole avocado. Some of my resetters will break it with ghee, MCT oil. Maybe you do at that point, you do some coffee with some MCT oil. But the idea is that when you break it with fat and then you wait a couple more hours before you have your first official meal, that you're gonna discover that fat curbs your hunger and doesn't stimulate your blood sugar and allows you to fast longer. So that's one of the key concepts to autophagy fasting, is giving you that perspective of what fat can do for your body. And if this is all new to you, follow me on Instagram, join me in my resetter group and Facebook, where we're giving a lot of the ideas, the community page here on YouTube. We're trying to give you guys ideas of what fat you would want to break this with. So keeping your protein down, fast at least 17 hours, break your fast with fat. Those are critical pieces of autophagy fasting. So now remember, more than any other fast, when you stimulate autophagy, you're also stimulating your body's self-detox mechanisms. So if you're just doing, let's say, intermittent fasting, you'll get a little bit of autophagy, not a ton. That's why I like you to go to about 17 hours. But you do get, like with intermittent fasting, you'll get some growth hormone that gets secreted, your blood sugar is gonna come down, you might get some ketones, but you don't necessarily get the really deep detoxing that autophagy can give you. So with autophagy fasting, you're not only helping increase ketones and lower blood sugar, but you're also encouraging that natural detox mechanism that you were born with, that your miraculous body has within it to heal. You're stimulating that. So if I go back to weight loss, this is really important, because weight loss is, hopefully you understand that weight loss is not a game of eat less. Weight loss is about controlling hormones like insulin and detoxing the cells, so your cells and your brain know to communicate so that you can burn fat. So with autophagy fasting, we're really accomplishing both of those. So, hope that helps. Now, the last thing I want to dive into is, okay, well, if it's such a great fast, how often should you do it? Now, remember that I'm a huge fan of creating a fasting lifestyle. So I'm not looking for you to fall in love with one fast and just do it over and over and over again. That's actually a recipe for getting stuck, even if you do autophagy fasting over and over again. So I like, if you're trying to lose weight, I like to sprinkle in some autophagy fasting a couple of times a week, I think is great. There's something magical about going low protein, and then the next day, if you're doing a keto, you could bring those, you could do like a ketobiotic fast where you're up to 50 grams of protein, but you're keeping your carbs down. You could go watch the video that I did on protein cycling, where you would do autophagy fasting and then you mega load on protein the following day. So it's the in and out of all of these fasts that are gonna get you that next layer of healing that you're looking for. And I know that's confusing, which is why I'm trying to clarify it for you guys here. We're gonna dive into it deeper at the Reset Experience. So if you wanna join me live with fasting and detox experts on January 11th, we're gonna dive into that. I have a Forever Young Reset that's coming out mid-January. So if you want information on that, just put Forever Young Reset, and I take you through all of these different fasts so that you can experience it for yourself. Just because autophagy fasting worked really well for one person doesn't mean that it's going to necessarily be the right fast for you. You should experiment with it, try it. You understand the principles of it now, and test it out, see how it works. But what the miracle is for everybody is the in and out of all the different fasts that gives you that fasting lifestyle where the body can really amp up its healing power and you can finally live in the body that you've dreamed of living in. We are miraculous. And if you think back, you go back to like caveman days. We had times where we would have tons of food accessible to us, and we had winters where we had nothing accessible to us. So our body is meant to be in this feast moment and then a famine moment and then a feast and a famine. But what we're doing in our society right now is we're eating all day and we're trying to always manipulate the types of foods that we're eating. And what I'm trying to teach you guys here on this channel is that there are 7 different types of fasts. There are a lot of different ways you can eat. And if you understand the principles, then you can tap into your body's own innate and inborn way of fasting and eating, and you'll finally live in the body that you want to live in. So, okay, that's autophagy fasting. If you want more information on our reset experience, just put reset experience in there. If you want to do the Forever Young reset, I take you through autophagy, stem cells, fat burning, microbiome repair. It is an 18-day experience. I'm really excited to bring it to you. So you just put Forever Young reset in there and we'll get you some information on it. But as always, I hope that helps.